London is very close to home. I'm from Copenhagen, Denmark, so this was very convenient for me to fly in. It's an hour and a half on a plane, so that was perfect. I have great friends here. London's always great to be in. I don't have a lot of time to see London this time because I'm leaving Sunday evening. Meeting fans is, I mean, we're so privileged to actually have the chance to meet the receivers of what we do. Because when you're on set working long hours, we have fun. It's great. I'm not complaining. But it's weird. You go back to your hotel room. I was in Canada shooting Legends. My hair is not really good, right? No. I was in Canada shooting Legends, and I had two kids and a wife. That sort of comes as a package. And going back from set and just settling into your hotel room and not knowing what the fuck you did actually all day, not meeting the audience, and it's a very different thing. So these conventions are so great that you actually meet people that enjoy what you do. So I'm very privileged to be invited to these things. It was a struggle. It was, I had so much fun, really. I really enjoy working. Playing the big bad is like, I always get cast back home in Denmark as the like pretty boy or the homosexual. And I don't know why, but I guess the funny accent and the high hairlines was kind of working out for me. And I when I auditioned for Vandal Savage, I had a little idea of who he was, and I start doing a lot of research, and I actually find out I look like this guy. I could actually pull this off. So, and just being able to work with these great colleagues on a great show. I'm an adult, and we get to play with knives and fight and, you know, just break things and say stupid words. And just, I'm so privileged. It's, I'm just smiling all over, so I guess you can see I really enjoyed it.
Is there a particular time period that you were in that you enjoyed the most?
Yeah, I think actually, I don't know, I always end up answering the 50s. We shot the 50s with Joe Dante, the like a legendary director, and just working with him was amazing. I don't know what was appealing about the 50s. I think it was the whole 50s aesthetics, the cars and the suits and the politeness and all that covered up in these. The 50s was, I think it was my favorite, maybe not episode, but sort of time period to be in. I wanted to be sort of a pirate at once, if I could choose. But that's maybe in the future, I don't know. I insist on doing as much as the fights as I'm capable of. I've been, you know, training at a national theater school in Denmark for 4 years, and not fighting is not incorporated in that, but we have a lot of sort of physical acting and stuff, and I find it really entertaining. So, I mean, I would say 80% I did myself, and of course, if they wanted to sort of throw me, out of a window, I'll call in my double, but I would actually ask for it. I could totally do that. And they were like, no, you were not allowed to. So, I mean, most of it, but we had a really, really strict time schedule. So usually I would get the fight scenes choreographed on video, like in the morning, and we would shoot it the same day. Like, so you have to learn your lines, and we changed that, by the way. And then you have to learn this fight. And I was just looking at my iPad, trying to sort of mirror what was going on. But we always ended up kind of doing, all of the fighting, and then covering it up with the doubles afterwards. So, and I really missed that. That was a lot of fun. and me and Falk Hawkman, we became really close friends, and we had this thing going on when we had the fights that a few of the punches would be real just between him and I, just to get that energy going. If we were tired at night, it was just, you know, and doing the whole sequence, and suddenly I could just feel a fist into my face, like, bam, okay. You're up next, buddy. And then I would punch him in the stomach, or, yeah, we're really close. That was probably the biggest, my biggest fear when I got this part. I was like, all right, one thing is that I kind of look like the guy, but all the fans has a big history with this person. He's been around for a long time in the comics. And like on Smallville, there was like a little, you know, not Vandal Savage, but Dr. Knox, right? Or something, right? Yeah. And I wanted to make it my own and not copy what was in the comics. But kind of, I don't know, I tried to put a lot of humor in it. And I tried to make him not just a one-dimensional evil person. I wanted to make him a person that you could actually relate to. And who I actually see him as a modern politician. I think he thinks he's doing the right thing for the world. And a huge part of the world is just sitting watching it like, you're on the wrong track, buddy. So I don't know. I try to. Yeah, yeah. They actually spelled my name wrong when I on my plane ticket. My name is Crump. It didn't say Trump, but it said Crunk. So and I was like, well, a good thing is that it's not Trump, and they left. But I don't know, I just try to make him like a whole person, make him a person that has feelings and can be sad and can be funny and can be, you know, I see him as this ghost writer, you know, a ghost writer riding on the highway, on the radio, comes a statement saying, there's a ghost writer on that and that highway, and he's the one saying, well, he's not the only one. So he thinks that everyone else are going against him. And he's actually the guy in trouble, not knowing it. I knew it wasn't like a one episode thing. I knew it was like the main villain of season one, at least. That's but I kind of didn't know the character that much. I started researching, and as I mentioned, and yeah, I just found out that this guy was actually, because I get a lot of auditions and you go like, I can't, that would never work out. But with this guy, I don't know, I just felt differently. And it was the worst audition I ever did. I shot it on my phone in my living room in Copenhagen. And I have two kids, at that time I had one. And it was my, I should pick her up from kindergarten. And I had no time, and the guy helping me out with the audition, he canceled on me. So he canceled on me, and I was like, oh, they need this tape in like 20 minutes. So I called up my neighbor, and he's never done anything like this, like reading lines or anything. So he came in. He's a really nice guy. And I said, just press record and read these lines, and I'll do my very best. And he did, but he thought that Vandal Savage was French. So he was like, so, Vandal Savage, what do you think? I was like, no, this is not working out. And in the middle of the audition, this brass band comes out in front of my apartment, just... And he was like speaking French to me, and I was sitting there all dressed up in long hair, and I was like, this is so fucked up, this is not going to work out. We did a few takes, and I was like, it was really one of those things. I was like, I'm not, just send it over and forget about it. 3 days later, they called back and said, that was amazing. You got the job. I was like, you kidding me?
Yeah, so that was perfect. So a big thanks to the brass band. Great soundtrack for Vandal's Habits, right? Anyway.
The format of series is like the kind of, not the new black, but, you know, transforming all this content from comics can't be done in a feature a year or two features or... And I totally get why they do it. And I would love, I mean, if I got offered one, I would totally do it. But the series format is perfect for this much content. You know, comics come out all the time. So to cram that into an hour and a half, twice a year, is not enough. I think that's why it's working out, actually. And I think that's why Legends is working out, because it wasn't the first one, but it's incorporating all these crossovers with Arrow and Flash and Supergirl now, and I know there's going to be more that I can't tell you guys about. And so I guess that's why it works out, and being a part of that is just amazing. Someone asked me, oh, wouldn't you just rather play Vandal Savage on the big screen? I was like, nah, not really. I don't have that urge. I think this format for telling these stories are perfect.